Hello, this is Andrew Klein. This is a video series which deals with the principles of 3D modeling. This is actually the second video set in this series. The first video series actually dealt with creating a chair from polygon geometry. That was a video series which looked at using polygon primitives, namely the polygon cube, to create a more complex object. That video looked at grouping using the hypergraph, duplicating. It also dealt with creating geometry or new components for geometry at the time an object is created, but didn't really deal with creating new components after the geometry has been created. And that's going to be one of the key focuses of this video, which is going to be creating a toy using both NURBS and polygon geometry. Now, this is the toy that I've chosen to create. It's a toy rooster. Looking at it, I'm actually going to break this down into sort of two different parts. One part is going to be built from NURBS geometry. One part is going to be built from polygon geometry. Then the whole element is going to be grouped together at the end to create a finished piece, even though it'll be very rough and maybe not perfect according to production standards. It will be a very good approximation of what we're looking at here. Now, when I'm looking at these shapes, I'm actually going to be using NURBS spheres, which are inherently curvilinear, to build most of the form. In fact, the body, which I'm tracing the outline of currently, I kind of see that as like a jelly bean type shape, and I'm going to actually create that by squishing and squashing a sphere. The wings as well are sort of like half circles on either side, just like this comb along the top and little waddle along the bottom. Now the beak and the feet I'm actually going to create from polygon geometry, because you can especially see it with the feet. There's going to be a much higher need for arbitrary redirection of my grid flow, which is not something, as you're going to see in just a bit, that NURBS are capable of doing. I'll finish this up by creating a little base piece from a squished sphere, and that will complete my toy. But just note, we're going to be working with both NURBS and polygon geometry bits, and we're going to be looking at concepts such as inserting an isoparm and extruding edges, both for NURBS and for polygons. Now, in previous videos, we've looked at using polygons, so you might be in the polygon menu set, and you might have your polygon shelf open. Well, we're going to start off working with NURBS geometry in this tutorial. So I'm going to switch to the surfaces menu set for my drop-down menu in the upper left corner of Maya. That will change my top menus to display Edit Curves, Surfaces, Edit NURBS, and Subdivisional Surfaces. In my shelf tabs, if I have polygons or some other shelf open, I'm going to make sure that I actually select the Surfaces shelf for this. One other thing that I'm going to go ahead and do is that underneath my Create window, under Create, NURBS Primitives, I'm going to make sure interactive creation is turned off for this process. Leaving it on is going to create geometry essentially anywhere. And when I create my spheres, I want them to default to the center of my grid, right at that origin, as you see right here. So this has me set up and ready to go. And my first step is going to be to create that basic body shape. Now, just like any other project you'll be working on, I want to make sure that my model is actually built corresponding, and as I hit spacebar here, you can see, I can build this corresponding to the four panels, the top view, the front view, and the side view. Since I want the front of my chicken to be facing forward in the front view, you'll notice that the Z-axis actually faces forward in that direction. From the side, jump back to my perspective view. From the side, I want to make sure that this lateral axis is the x-axis. And up and down, of course, is going to be my y-axis. And that'll just help get me oriented correctly in this space. Well, I'm going to start off by creating a NURBS sphere primitive, a non-uniform rational B-spline sphere. So I will hit the sphere button in my surfaces shelf. And you'll notice that this circular object appears at my origin. Now, there's a couple of things here worth examining, first of all. One is that if I was to create a polygon sphere as well, my polygon sphere, let me make these roughly similar in their creation. My polygon sphere is going to be created by individual edges which are bounded by two vertices. If I right-click on my polygon sphere, you'll notice I have edge, vertex, and face as my primary components of this. A vertex is a single point, a edge is bounded by two vertices, and a face is bounded by multiple vertices and has area. Polygon surfaces are inherently angular because of this. Well, NURB surfaces are inherently smooth, but when you create yours, you might not actually see it as smooth as what you see on my screen. The smoothness display settings can be toggled by using the keyboard shortcuts of 1, 2, and 3, becoming more and more rounded as you go. Now let's examine some of the properties of this sphere as we start creating our model. If I right-click on this model and hold down that right-click button, you'll notice that the components aren't the same at all. First of all, I have control vertices instead of vertices. And these control vertices don't actually sit right on the model itself. That's kind of peculiar until you right-click on the model and examine the hull. The hull is sort of an outer cage around the model. And you'll notice that at the corners of that cage, well, that's where my control vertices are. If I right-click on the model and choose isoparm, you'll notice that I can select any one of these long continuous edges that wrap around the model. I can choose both a line of longitude, as you see here, or a line of latitude, which wraps horizontally. Well, it's interesting to note that unlike a polygon model, where an edge is bounded between only two vertices, on a NURBS model, this isoparm is going to continue around the entire form. It's unbounded. And that's what helps it create curvature. You'll also notice that on a NURBS sphere like this one of your edges, or one of your isoparms, I should say, is going to be a thicker green line than the other ones. It's going to be a little bit wider than the other lines. This is actually your seam. Now, to examine this concept a little bit further, I'm going to compare this NURBS sphere to a NURBS plane. And I'm going to go in the attribute editor, the middle tab, which is my initial creation attributes. And I'm going to give a couple more patches in the U and V direction. Now you'll see here that the edges of this, those bounding isoparms, are still a thicker green. That's what you're seeing here on this shape. In fact, it might even become a little bit more apparent if I go into the middle tab of the sphere, the Make NURB Sphere tab, and I edit the Start Sweep or End Sweep. You'll see what happens here is that my sphere is actually going to open up. And what the sphere actually is sort of a pinched up version, a version of this plane which has been rounded together and then pinched at the poles. As such, it does have a seam along one side. And it's important to notice that as you work with this model. In our next video, we're going to take a look at positioning this seam so that we have it along the correct axis of orientation and so that we can divide our model in half. We're also then going to start pushing and pulling this sphere a little bit further with a duplicate instance. So please hold on for video number 2.